We good? I'd like to thank everybody here for tuning into this PTCI live stream as we have the Spearman Lynx taking on the Canadian Wildcats here on Tuesday evening, January 17th in Spearman, Texas. As we get set for tip-off here, the Wildcats get it. Number 5, Samantha Kriebel. Wildcats here going to be working around. We got an early foul here, and your starters for your Canadian Wildcats is number 5, Samantha Kriebel. Number 3, Berkeley Beattie. Number 12, Reese Adams. Number 20, Kylie Cavalier. And Brooklyn Cochran, number 21. That first free throw there is good by Adams. The Lynx bring it up here. Number 11, Braylon Lusby, passing out to the corner. Canadian Wildcats here going with a man to start off, and we got a jump ball. Good defensive play there by the Wildcats. Leslie working the point, driving to her left. Back out to 13-13 for the layup. That layup is good there by Lexi Kafka. Wildcats passing out for 3. That is good by number 21, Brooklyn Cochran. Wide open in the corner is Cochran. Lusby trying to work to her left, and she gets called fair for a carry. And Cavalier inbounding it there to Kriebel, Samantha Kriebel. Wildcats working their offense around. Quick passes on the outside. Both teams going here with a man early in the first quarter. Kriebel driving in, loses the ball. We got a scramble for it. We got a jump ball here called. That'll stay here with Canadian under their own basket. Canadian leading here 5-2. Still with 6 minutes. Oh, and that pass goes out of bounds. And the Lynx bringing it back up here. Going to her left, back to her right is number 11, Braylon Lusby. Wildcats keeping the pace up. Not showing any signs of slowing down. And one there for number 12, Reese Adams. Adams free throw is no good. Wilkinson trying to get a pass off here. Into Lusby. Lusby's shot is not there. Off on Spearman, it's Canadian's ball. Thank you. an offense set up here. They are coached by Aaron Marks. He's getting the play call in here from the sideline. 3-point shot there for Canadian. Not there. And Lesby bringing it up the court herself. Working the right side. Trying to draw a foul. Not going to get it called. On the fast break up here for the Wildcats is number 21, Booker Cocker. We got a foul here called on the Wildcats. Lynx are gonna pass it in from underneath their own basket out to the 3-point line. Oh. Getting some separation there, but not being able to convert. And we've got an off-the-ball foul here on the attempted rebound. That'll be foul will be called on number 24, Aubrey and Brett. Converted there by number 3, Berkeley Beatty. Beatty shot, no good. And that shot, airballed, trying to get a foul called. Looks like Spearman will not get one. And that pass goes out of bounds. Costly turnover there for the Wildcats. I thought they called that out of bounds. Never mind, that was a foul there on number 12. Lesby getting the call in from her coach. Trying to get some screen set there for Lesby. They're calling that one on the ground. Lots of early fouls here for both teams. Already 7 fouls called here in the first 5 minutes of the game. Good defense there by the Wildcats. We've got a really hard physical game here by both teams. Wildcats shooting for 3. Not there. Rebounded by Lesby. Lesby looking for the screen. Gonna pass it around. Lynx trying to drive inside. And the shot is good there by number 22, Delgado. We got a timeout here with 2:24 left, score 11-6. come out here. Number 21, Cochran, bringing it up for the Wildcats. Oh, the 3-point, no good. Got a mad tussle for the ball, and we're gonna get a jump ball call here. Spearman's ball. Lesby getting the offense set up here for the Lynx. Just not a good pass there down low, and that goes out of bounds. Going in, getting into the game here for helping the Lynx defense out. Canadian working the high post, not there. Got some passes going around. Good defense there by the Lynx. Getting a screen set. Wildcats trying to work the offense. Not a good shot there for the Wildcats. The Lynx get the rebound, working it back up the court. No one's going to stop the ball out to the three-point line for three. That's off the front of the rim. We got a fast break opportunity here for the Wildcats. And that is good by number 5, Samantha Creevel. Her first points of the game. Spearman coach trying to get a foul call down there on that last shot. He's been in the ear of the referee in this whole first quarter. Trying to get some separation. Lesby trying to drive inside. For three. Oh, that's in and out. 14 seconds here left. And they're going to give to their best player, number 12. That is not a good shot. We get a jump ball here. And man, we're hearing that here from the Spearman crowd. As they wanted something extra there. And they're not gonna get it. That stays here on here with Canadian. Just under 5 seconds here for three. Was good there by number 21, Brooklyn Cochran, your leading scorer in the first quarter with 8 points for the Canadian Wildcats. And we'll be back here to start the second quarter. Spearman will get the ball here to start the second quarter. Riggins almost had a bad pass there, got it saved. Back out to Riggins on that corner. And we got a double dribble there. Canadian here will get the ball after that double dribble. Busby looking to drive out to Witten for three. That's no good there. Canadian for three on the corner. And we got a foul after the shot. Number 24 bodied on after the shot. I'm not sure anybody in the stadium understood what that call was, even the coaches. And we got another foul here called on number 12 with the push. Take the ball about the court after that wild series of events here. To the corner. Delgado over to Kafka, back to Lusby. Kafka for three. Not there. Rebound there by Witten. We got a jump ball call there. And it's going to be Canadian's ball after that jump ball. Court here for the Wildcats. It's Kriebel over to number 20 to Cochran. Back to Adams. And another foul call here. Number 10 on the block. Needless to say, we got a very physical game here. Nobody scored yet here in the second quarter, 16-6. For three, not there. Foul on the three-pointer is number 5, Samantha Kriebel. And I think what we might have just seen there was a pretty good frustration foul. And Creeble's second shot is good. And she makes all three free throws, bringing her total for the night up to 5 points. 19-6 lead here for the Wildcats. Let's be looking inside. That's intercepted. And they'll be in the bonus here after that foul on number two. Shooting 1-1 will be number 21, Brooklyn Cochran. Passing it inside out to the corner for three. And those shots just aren't landing tonight for the Lynx. Lynx trying to work it around to the right side. Quick passes out to the corner. Looking for three again. Not there. And on the fast break, it's Cochran. Get a jump ball called here. And that'll stay down there with the Wildcats. Spearman working the ball around here. 4.5 minutes left in the second quarter. And drawing a foul is number 11, Braylon Lusby. Must be missing her second one. Canadian getting the offense set up here. Getting tight pressure there by the Wildcats. Wildcats look at moving more to a zone here now. That three-pointer not there. And that'll be the Lynx ball. For three, off the front of the rim. And the Wildcats get the rebound, working the fast break. And we got a foul called here on number 33. That'll send the Wildcats to the line again. That is good. making her first, missing her second. Up is number 12, Reese Adams, with the putback there, giving them a 22-7 lead over the Lynx. And the Lynx have not been able to get down inside the basket all night. Lusby jawing the foul there. Lusby making her first one. Missing her second, but getting the rebound are the Lynx. We got a foul called here. Number 14 on the black. And that'll move them into the bonus. The Wildcats have been very physical, not letting the Lynx cut to the basket. Sometimes that results in some unnecessary foul trouble for the Wildcats. Leslie makes both of those, making this 22-10 here with 3 minutes left. Spearman still sticking with their defense here. Get some help from the crowd. The Wildcats here changing the offensive play there. And get called for a double dribble. Minutes here in the second quarter. Lusby working around, getting the jump shot. Good for Braylon Lusby. She passed right whenever the person she was passing to made a cut. Cost a turnover, and the momentum has quickly shifted here to the Spearmen as they are on a 6-0 run. Spearmen trying to get some more points here. Driving to the hoop, pulling up. That's off the back of the rim. For three, the Wildcats, and that is good for Brooklyn Cochran. She has been automatic from the corner there. 11 points here in the first half. And a foul here called. As we have multiple members for the Wildcats have two fouls here in the second quarter. They keep this up here, they'll be in foul trouble coming the fourth quarter. And an unnecessary over the back, and number 13 knew it there for right as it got called. Was shooting that double bonus down here. Adams makes her first free throw. Misses her second. Witten for three. And that is good. For number 10, Lady Witten. Just under a minute here, and the Wildcats looked up. They're content with slowing it down. But we have the Spearman crowd getting into it. Seconds now. Wildcats trying to hold for the last shot. Good play there by number 10, Lady Witten. She saw that one coming, and the Lynx here have a chance to take the last shot here in the second quarter. Screen set there for Lusby. Hard screen for three. Not there. 6 seconds left. And they're going to call that a foul on number 33. I for sure thought that was a jump ball call. Making the first one. Adams. Loves be taken in here with 3 seconds, 2, 1. The shot is not off here at the end of the first half. We have the score, Canadian Wildcats 28 and Spearman Lynx 15. We'll be back here in about 10 minutes here to start the third quarter.
you can manage your home Wi-Fi network right from your smartphone? With PTCI Whole Home Wi-Fi, you can quickly and easily manage your home Wi-Fi through your PTCI Wi-Fi app. Set your Wi-Fi password, view connected devices, run speed tests, set up parental controls, and more. Experience the best in home Wi-Fi with PTCI Wi-Fi app. Call now and get 3 months free of Whole Home Wi-Fi and visit PTCI.net to download the app today.
We're back here to start the third quarter play as the Wildcats here get the ball for the third quarter, trying to extend on their 13-point lead. Adams gets called for a travel there. Lesby bringing it up here for the Spearman Lynx. Driving to the right side. Oh, and with the shot. Not there. And they're calling that off of the Canadian Wildcats. Lynx trying to pass it in here. Lesby taking it, driving to our left side, spinning it around. Drawing the foul. Lesby's free throw, not there. Lesby missing both free throw attempts at the line there. Adams with the ball. Moving right to left, quick passes. Here for the Wildcats. trying to get some separation on the man coverage. And good block here by the Lynx, working it down low. And we get a foul called here on, looks like to be number 20. Kylie Cavalier. And that free throw is not good here. Spearman not doing so great from the free throw line. And they've left 4 points there on the line, which is really big here on a 13-point game just here in the third quarter. It's one thing to draw the foul, but another thing, you gotta make those shots when they count. Wildcats making some quick passes on the outside, trying to get a work for a high post. We got a card here and called number 21. Brooklyn Cochran. And that is her fourth foul of the game in the third quarter. The leading scorer here for the Wildcats. Their leading scorer for the Wildcats, and the Wildcats coach, Aaron Marks, is not happy at all with that call. And he's just letting the refs hear it. It's not good when you gotta have your star player on the bench because of foul trouble. And we got another foul here, number 12 on the grab. That's the second leading scorer for the Wildcats. She now has 3 fouls. And all this foul trouble, this leads a good opening here for the Lynx to get momentum and get back in this game if they can just make some shots. Lesby steps on the line, out of bounds. Wildcat ball. Trying to get some passes in here. It goes to Adams. We get a foul called here on number 24 for the Spearman Lynx. On the defense, 24 on the defense gets called with a foul. Tight defense here by the Lynx here as they get into tight man D. Good defense there by the Lynx, trying to create a turnover here. Doll on the double team. And a timeout here called by a Canadian. 30-second timeout here with 4.5 minutes left to play. Looking to pass it. Good defense there by number 22 for the Lynx. Free will passing out to the edge, all the way over, swinging it over, looking for the three-point shot, not going to take it. Wildcats being patient with the ball. Trying to look inside, it's not there. Wildcats being patient, they get some passes, nothing going inside though yet. Finally getting a pass inside, back out for three. Not there, off the front of the rim. Lusby bringing it up here for the Lynx. Getting the screen set, Lusby freeing herself up. That falls short off the front of the rim. She had an open lane there if she wanted to take it. Adams passing it back over to Kriegel. Trying to get some movement here are the Wildcats. Still a score of 28-15 here. And they're not going to call that elbow there. We finally get a call here on the ground. That was on the ground. Wildcats inbounding it here. And now we got a foul call. It's on number 22, that's our third foul. That sends number 20, Kylie Cavalier, to the line. Cavalier with her first points. Cavalier making both free throws. Wildcats have been a lot better at the line today than the Lynx. Getting passed over there by the Lynx. Trying to get somebody open, cut to the basket. Quick movement there. And we get a foul called here. On number three. That was called on number three for the Canadian Wildcats, Berkeley Beattie. Scoring here in the third quarter. A lot more fouls. We've already had 8 fouls called here and only 4 points scored. Good offensive rebound there for the Lynx for 3. And number 10, Lady Witten, her second three-pointer of the day. Travel is called here on number 5. Thirty to 18 is your score here with just over a minute in the third quarter. The Lynx have got to get more points on the board if they want to come back That is not a good pass. And Samantha Kriebel losing her footing and dropping the ball out of bounds. Lynx get the ball back. Lesby getting a screen set. Hard screen set there for the Lynx. Over to the corner to Lesby. For three again. Not there. We're going to get a jump ball called here. And it stays down here with Spearman. Getting the ball here. Not there. Getting it on rebound. And one for Braylon Lesby. That's 11 points here for Braylon Lesby. Wildcats here are going to try to hold for the last shot. Just under 10 seconds here. 5, 4, 3. And a foul called here. Number 23. Ella Wilkerson, 2.2 seconds here. Got to have a quick shot inbounds. Out of the three-point line is number 14 for three. And that is short. So here at the end of the third quarter, we got a score of 30-21. Canadians still leading. Wildcats will get the ball here to start the fourth quarter here in Spearman, Texas. As we have a close one here. It's gotten closer as the game's got along. 30-21 is the lead. Wildcats in foul trouble. Oh, looking inside. Kriebel barely able to get a hand on that one. They're going to get the play set back up here. Adams looking to drive to her left. And she scores. Lesby going to her left. Out for three. Oh, and that's no good there. for Wilkerson. I'm not sure what call we have here. Oh, we got a timeout here by Spearman. Delgado playing the point here for the Lynx. Inside to Lusby. Lusby loses the ball in the post. And Kriebel on the fast break opportunity. And we got a 3-point opportunity there, and it's in and out for the Wildcats. Wilkerson passes it back to Lusby. Crazy series of events right there, as the Mavs could have had one or two foul calls, nothing called at all. Lusby frees himself up. Lynx trying to double team. Out to the corner for three. Not there. Nobody to rebound for the Lynx. Back up and in there for number 20. We have a timeout here on the Wildcats. Five and a half minutes left here to play, and the Lynx are down by 11. Trying to get someone open cut to the basket, not there for Spearman. Driving to the left, passing it back out. Delgado. Taking a screen, freezing herself up, and she is fouled there by number 20, Cavalier. Delgado's first free throw, not there. Spearman down by 10. Wildcat trying to hold on that lead. And we get a foul called here. On number 24, Aubrey Beck. Wildcats passing around, passing it out, taking the three-point shot. Not there, good rebound there by the Lynx. And the shot does not fall but two, but we do get a foul called there. That'll send number 23, Ella Wilkerson, to the line. Wilkerson making her first free throw. Second one falls for Wilkerson. Down by just now eight. That last foul there moved Spearman into the bonus. Wildcats passing the ball out, looking for an open three. That's intercepted there by number 13, Lexi Klafka. Klafka dribbling to the right. And she gets called there for a charge. Oh, good defense there by the Lynx. Wildcats is content with passing the ball around. And Klafka gets called for a foul. Sends number 12, Reese Adams, to the line. She misses. Delgado on the hour. They call a double dribble there on Delgado. Dribble out to the arc to Adams. Wildcats, they're just gonna stall here and pass as much as they can without taking a shot. The Lynx trying to intercept that pass. A hard hit there as number 11 picks up her second foul, sending number 5. Samantha Kriebel to the line. Oh, Creeble missing. Lynx still down here by 8. Lesby trying to take a shot. Not there. Cats here, they're just gonna pass it around and pass it out of bounds. And we got timeout here called by Canadian, just under 2 minutes. Wildcats up by 8. Spearman here. We got a stoppage of play here. Not sure what for. Lesby taking the inbound pass over to Delgado. Over to Witten. Witten to Lesby. And they're calling that on the ground. The shot will not count. Well, that sends her shooting 1-1. In and out there for Lesby. And that stays here with the Wildcats. Good defensive play there by the Lynx. Lynx bringing the full court press here. Out here at Wildcats. It's a minute 23, up by 8. We'll be right back. the last 2 minutes have been long. Spearman Lynx bringing the press here. And now we got a timeout here by Spearman. Canadian trying to pass it in here. Lynx bringing the press. And that goes out of bounds. Spearman gets the ball down by 8. And we got another timeout here by Spearman. Inbound goes here to Lusby. Getting a screen set there, trying to work to the left side. Not there. And a foul is called there. Number 23. Seems Creeble to the line shooting 1-1. She makes it. That'll be 14th, fifth foul of the game here. Lusby will be shooting. Making a first one. And missing the second. And we get a jump ball call here. Spearman down by 9. Need to get a quick shot here with 50 seconds. Out here called by on number 11. And Adams makes her 12th point, making her the leading scorer of the night for the Wildcats. As they go up by 10, and we got another timeout. Adams makes her second one. Spearman hurrying down the court quick. And as dribble off the foot, makes it Canadian's ball. As they're up by 11 here with 38 seconds. Intercepted there by Kafka. No foul called. And we get a foul there on number 11, Braylon Lusby. Canadian having a chance to go up here by 13. No bonus. with 20 seconds here. Wildcats up by 11. Wildcats up by 13. Lynx bringing the ball up. Delgado over to Kafka. Get called a kick here, and it stays here with Spearman.
I don't want to call anything.
Eight seconds left here in the game. Spearman trying to inbound it. Witten with the layup. And it goes out of bounds. And Wildcats here have 1.5 seconds left till victory. And we got another foul here. With 0.4 seconds left. That shot is no good. And here at the end of this one, we have a score of Canadian Wildcats 43, Spearman Lynx 29. We'll be back here about 10 minutes to get the boys' game going.
You can manage your home Wi-Fi network right from your smartphone. With PTCI Whole Home Wi-Fi, you can quickly and easily manage your home Wi-Fi through your PTCI Wi-Fi app. Set your Wi-Fi password, view connected devices, run speed tests, set up parental controls, and more. Experience the best in home Wi-Fi with PTCI Wi-Fi app. Call now and get 3 months free of Whole Home Wi-Fi and visit PTCI.net to download the app today.
Hello everyone. Today we are in Perryton, Texas at Bee's Wildflower, and I'm here with Betty Smith, the proprietor of this business. Betty, thanks for joining us today. Tell us a little bit about the history of Bee's Wildflower and kind of where the idea started as well.
Well, thank you guys for coming. We appreciate you, the opportunity for you guys to allow us to share our story. So thank you for being here. My story begins as a little girl coming from a big family, and my mother always baking and cooking and doing everything from scratch. And so as a young girl, of course, all of us kids were in the kitchen and learning together. And I loved the art of baking. I loved the art of creating different dishes and desserts. And so that's where it all began. One of my sisters took the direction of doing wedding cakes and that sort of thing. So she taught me a lot on that perspective. So I have a sister that's about 7 years older than me that really loved the decorating and stuff. And so we would take some classes together and enjoy it. And so that's kind of where it all started. When we were trying to figure out what our slogan would be, Better Together was the perfect fit, which came from my daughter. And she thought that sounded great because we are, as a community, better together. And being better together starts with a good community that believes in small businesses and having employees come out and enjoy their jobs and realizing that what we're doing as a community project is what we're giving back to our people. And so having that mindset is part of our training in the beginning of why that's important and how we treat our customers and the quality of products that we want to make sure that our customers are able to enjoy when they shop here at Bee's Wildflower. So by opening the business here, that was our main objective, is to bring a good quality product, homemade product, to the table for Perryton to enjoy and the surrounding areas, of course. So
now let's kind of get to, you know, you said you love baking, you love being part of the Perryton community and everything. What do you love to make here that people love to come in and get as well?
We have a variety of, quite a bit of variety here at Bee's Wildflower. We have, first and foremost, we have our coffee shop that we brought to the table that we are excited about. We have botanical teas that we make on hand that are sweetened with organic sweeteners like agave in the raw, honey in the raw, and then sugar in the raw, and stevia in the raw. So we really cue in on people that are more health conscious and want to do good for their body. Maybe they don't like coffee, but they enjoy a cup of tea. And so we have quite a few of those available here at Bee's Wildflower that is steeped when the customer orders it. So we're super excited about that. And as far as the baking goes, we have anywhere from edible cookie dough that people are excited about. You can have that in a fresh made cone that we make here at Bee's Wildflower. We have the what we call the Big Betties, which is any of our cookies that we make from scratch. You can sandwich those together with our light and fluffy buttercream.
Well, it sounds like you got a fantastic place here. I know just the aroma when we came in, just all the different things we were smelling. Saw a little toddler already getting a nice little cake pop this morning and enjoying that. And it's just a great little place to visit. You know, if you like coffee shops, if you like baked goods, it's a great place to stop in here. Bee's Wildflower in Perryton. Betty, we appreciate you joining us today. One other thing I would add was, you know, PTCI, we offer some great services down here in Perryton, our internet, phone service, and things like that. How does that help you continue to do the business that you do here?
Yes, sir. We love PTCI. We couldn't do it without you. And so we run all of our internet is through PTCI. Our phones are through PTCI. Our POS system is through PTCI. So we truly couldn't do it without you guys. We have had a great experience with PTCI. We haven't had any, you know, hiccups along the way or anything, so that's been great. So PTCI and what you guys have provided for us to be able to operate this business successfully.
Well, Betty, we sure appreciate you joining us and letting us come down here and just experience your little store here. It's a beautiful little place. If you haven't been here, like I said, come on down to Perryton, visit Bee's Wildflower. Thanks again, Betty.
Thank y'all.
know you can manage your home Wi-Fi network right from your smartphone? With PTCI Whole Home Wi-Fi, you can quickly and easily manage your home Wi-Fi through your PTCI Wi-Fi app. Set your Wi-Fi password, view connected devices, run speed tests, set up parental controls, and more. Experience the best in home Wi-Fi with PTCI Wi-Fi app. Call now and get 3 months free of Whole Home Wi-Fi and visit PTCI to download the app today.
Here for tuning back into this second game we have going on here on Tuesday, January 17th in Spearman, Texas, where we have the Canadian Wildcats visiting here at the Spearman Lynx. As we get ready to set for a tip-off, your starting lineups for your Canadian Wildcats are number 2, Trace Mitchell, number 4, Preston Miller, number 5, Nathan Wagner, number 10, Jackson Valenzuela, and number 11, Cameron Cavalier. In your lineups for your Spearman Lynx, number 11, Shad Whiteley, number 13, Kaysen Mackey, number 21, Jeb Garnett, number 25, Jack Davis, number 35, Jeb Jack Pipkin, and the Lynx here get the tip with Garnett leading it up here. Lynx trying to beat the defense here of the Wildcats. Wildcats come out here on a man D. Goes out here to Whiteley. Still working around here. Pipkin's shot is not there. Rebound there by the Lynx by number 13. Mackey with the layup. It is good by number 13, Kaysen Mackey. Cavalier for the Wildcats playing the point here. Sloppy pass in there early on for the Wildcats. Miller takes the first shot. And one here for number 4, Preston Miller. Miller's shot falls. Whiteley bringing it up here for Spearman, out for 3. Not there. That is saved there by the Lynx off of the back. Bounce off the back of the Wildcats. Lynx will have it underneath their own basket. Inbounded there. Mackey. Work on the inside. It's Pipkin. Pipkin. Draws a foul. And one. Jack Pipkin standing at 6'5", the junior. And Pipkin gets 3 points there for the Lynx. That ball is tipped there by Whiteley. Miller loses it. Preston Miller loses it on the fast break.
That is converted there by Jeb Garnett.
Cameron Cavalier passes it out there, out to Miller for three. That's in and out there. And the Lynx hurrying down the court time and time again. Dahl on a foul there. Number 13, Kaysen Mackey. And the Lynx showing their speed as they are converting on these fast breaks. Mackey's free throw is good. And his second free throw, no good there for Mackey. Trace Mitchell passing over to Miller. Miller out to Cavalier. Cavalier looking to drive, pulls up from the baseline. That is good there for Cameron Cavalier. Foul is called on number 5, Nathan Wagner. His second already. Mackey taking it in, but that gets called on the ground. Jack Pipkin scoring there for the Lynx off the inbound. A foul there called on number 11, Chad Whiteley. Miller driving around, looking inside. We get a foul called here on number 21. Miller out on the outside, and the Cavalier. Cavalier shot not there. Offense rebound, but no good on the putback there for the Wildcats. Mackey, out to the corner. That corner there is good by number 20, Marcos Varela. Cavalier gets called there for a travel. Make that foul number 9. Mackey looking to inbound it here. Into Whiteley. Mackey for 3. Not there. And Miller bringing it up the court. Miller over to Dominguez. Dominguez out to Valenzuela. Valenzuela sent back by Jack Pipkin. And Whiteley gets that ball stolen. And there's a travel there called on number 3. If you move in a 4 without dribbling. Yeah, he didn't. Yeah, he touched the ball and didn't dribble. And he slid on the floor. Whiteley. Gets it out there on the corner. Working to the left. To Pipkin. Pipkin work on the left side. Loses it, gets control. Oh, and that shot there is not there for Blaine Kafka. Kafka's gonna be inbounding here under his own basket. Spearman has the lead, 15-5. And that foul is called by number 21, Riggs Pennington. Already going to be shooting here, bonus, with 3 minutes left here in the first quarter. Pickens free throw, not there. Got another foul here off the ball. Number 11, Shab Whiteley. has it up on top of the key for three. Air ball by Miller. Looking inbound at the Lynx are.
Inbound's good though.
Curvin Quizada. In the corner, the Lynx have it. Out to Mackey. We got a foul call. Quizada? 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 Mackey's free throw is good. Already having 5 points today. Miller looking. Mackey with the rebound, bringing up the court, trying to get up there to Pipkin. It's not there. That's just a frustration foul there by the Lynx.
Get ready for air ball again.
Miller bringing up the court. Shot up there for the Wildcats, not converting. Lynx working it around here. Oh, good pass there by the Lynx. That is converted there by number 25, Jack Davis. Dominguez has it on top of the key. Passes it over to Valenzuela. Valenzuela to Miller. And the Lynx here. Getting pressured by the Wildcat full court press. Saving it. Up to Pipkin. Pipkin pass. Too long for Marcos Varela. Wildcats here holding for the last shot, down 19-5. 15 seconds left here to play in the first quarter. Preston Miller has it. 5 seconds here. Three. Miller for three. And that is good there, Preston Miller.
Here at the end of the first quarter, we have Spearman Lynx 19 and the Canadian Wildcats 8.
We'll be right back.
here to start the second quarter. Wildcats have the ball. Miller in the corner. Flowers. It's a turnaround. And a foul is called there on number 25. Came with the rebound out to Whiteley. Whiteley looking for the fast break. And it's out of bounds there. Spearman's ball. And off the inbound is number 21, Jeb Garnett, 4-3. Out to Cavalier. Miller. Mackey with the rebound. To Garnett. Whiteley has it guarded by into Pipkin. Pipkin not getting his own rebound. Drawing the foul. And is Jack Pipkin. And a jump ball here is called. Guarded here by Cavalier tightly, trying to get some separation, and he gets called for a carry. Cavalier bringing it up here for Canadian. Dominguez getting guarded tightly by Mackey. He's gonna set back up. Cavalier pulls up. That's good. Cameron Cavalier. Mackey for three. Not there. Rebounded by Riggs Pennington. Whiteley gets called with a block. That was a good call. Cavalier will be shooting 1-1 here. Go, 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 go. Jackie bringing up the court here for Spearman. Mackie getting double teamed here. Passes it out. Mackie in the corner. Timeout called here by Spearman with 5 minutes, 15 seconds. Off the inbound, wide open, missing the three-pointer, and Canadian finally gets the rebound. Cavalier getting the screen. Oh, and that's stolen there by number 21, Garnett. And to Pipkin.
Good, down low.
Cavalier wheels that one in there. Mackey bringing it up the court. Into Pipkin. Pipkin, good, down low.
And they have yet to be able to stop Pipkin
down low because he has 11 points already. Miller. Can we get a foul called here? On number 2, Kervin Quezada. Shot there by Valenzuela is good. And Valenzuela's second shot is good. And Kerving Quesadilla bringing it up the court here for the Lynx. Out to Mackey. Mackey for three. Not there. Cavalier shot not there. Lynx getting the rebound. Garnett. Passing it. Oh, and it's stolen there by Cavalier. Some fast break points here. Good for Trace Mitchell for the
Wildcats.
And Garnett here bringing the ball up the court here for the Lynx. Pipkin. Off the pick and roll. Good. Miller over to Valenzuela. Miller looking for the three-point shot, not gonna take it. Into Mitchell. Valenzuela for three. Not there. And we got a travel here called on number 20, Marco Cigarella. Cavalier pulls up. That's short. Rebounded by Mackey. Casey Mackey. Being patient with it. Down inside to Pipkin. Pipkin outside to Garnett. Getting a screen from Garnett. For three. Not there. Rebounded by Pipkin. Quesadilla has it out. Playing point guard. Mackey gets the inbound. Poke loose there, but able to corral it on the Lynx. Down low to Pipkin. Pipkin trying to work the inside. Not there. The 25 with it over the back there. That's Jack Davis. Moves him down into the bonus. And 23, Connor Miller. Making his first shot of the game. And Miller making his second one. Bringing it up the court. And to Davis. Davis over to Mackey. Mackey looking inside to Pipkin. Pipkin spins, makes a move, and up and in for Pipkin. Cavalier with a step back. We got a timeout here for the Wildcats here with 29 seconds left in the second quarter. We'll be right back. called for a travel there with 19 seconds. The Lynx bring it up here, 15 seconds left. Inside to Pipkin, Pipkin working it in. And he gets fouled there by number 5, Nathan Wagner. Pipkin making his first free throw. Missing the second. 6 seconds left here. Valenzuela over to Miller. Miller is attacking. And that is the end of the first half here as we have a score of Spearman 33, Canadian 18. We'll be back here in Portland for the third quarter. We'll be right back. Here we are, start the third quarter play here. Canadian has the ball. Cavalier passing it out. Canadian down by 15, trying to get back in this one. Cavalier for three. Not there. Mackey looking inbound here to Whiteley. Spearman Lynx looking to get inside there to Pipkin. Whiteley for three. Chad Whiteley for three. Trace Mitchell for three for the Wildcats. Pipkin out on the top of the key. Mackey inside the Pipkin. Pipkin down low. Not there. We got 25 with a foul. Cavalier looking to the left, out for three. De Valenzuela, not there. Davis, out to Whiteley. Whiteley into Pipkin. Pipkin, working down low, that falls. Pipkin now has 18 points on the day. That is good there for Mitchell. Mackey over to Whiteley. Mitchell trying to draw the charge. Not gonna happen. We'll have a call there. Garnett gets the rebound. Spearman trying to get a foul here. They're not going to get one. Mackey into Pipkin. Pipkin out to Davis. Davis a shot, not there. Rebounded by Miller. Cavalier shot, not going to fall. Mackey out to Whiteley. Garnett for three. Rebounded by Miller. 4 minutes left here in the third quarter. Cavalier loses his footing there, loses the ball. Taken by Davis. Davis over to Garnett. Pipkin. Looking inside, that's poked loose there by Miller. It'll stay here with Pipkin.
No fouls here. One foul call. Already halfway through the third.
And Mackey here is going to be inbounding it for Spearman. Whiteley looking for a shot. Passes over to Pipkin down low. Pipkin gets fouled there by number 21, Riggs Pennington. For Pipkin. Cavalier has the ball top of the key. Out to Dominguez. Dominguez over to Valenzuela. Pennington looks turned around, not there. Rebounded by Whiteley. Whiteley into Mackey. Mackey with a layup. We got a timeout here with 2:45 left. Spearman has a lead, 41-23. Mitchell for three, not there. And the shot there is good by number 32, Carson Seaman. Pennington down low. That foul there is called on number 24, Blake Klafka. Pennington makes 1-for-2 at the line. Under 2 minutes here in the third quarter. Klafka has the ball. Over to Seaman. Seaman with the shot. Not there. Dominguez out to Mitchell. Mitchell driving. Got an over the back there called on number 21, Riggs Pennington. And a bad pass there by Klafka. Turns the ball over. Minute 29 here. Mitchell. Over to Dominguez. Dominguez driving on the right side. And draws a foul there. By Carson Seaman. Dominguez's shot is good. Here we are back to start the fourth quarter. Whiteley bringing it in. With three. Not there. Rebounded there by Davis. They're trying to get the screen. The Cavalier shot is not there. Varela has the ball. Over to Whiteley. Whiteley dribbling to his left. And that's good. Mitchell, shot not there. Garnett lays it up and in. Mitchell over to a Cavalier. Pass is intercepted. Hit out of bounds. Dominguez inbound up here for the Wildcats. Over to Miller. Miller inside the Cavalier. Loses the ball there. Taken up there by Miller. Cavalier has it. spinning around. That's short. Gets his own rebound. And Davis has it there. Draws a foul. And that'll be Nathan Wagner's fifth foul of the game. We got a timeout here by Spearman. 5:35 left, they're up by 22. Pipkin looking to inbound here. He inbounds out to Davis. Davis spins. Shot not there. Saved by Varela. Miller is past center, set today by Pipkin. Mackey getting guarded tight there. Mackey, layup, oh, in and out. Pipkin shot not there either. That's intercepted there by Varela. Varela working. Out of bounds there by number 10, Jackson Valenzuela. Davis gets the inbound pass. Varela gets over to Davis, but saved there by Mackey. Mackey passes it in to Pipkin. Pipkin out to Varela for three. That's good. Rebounded there by the Wildcats. For three, Miller, not there. Pipkin passes it to Mackey. Mackey looking inside to Davis. Bad pass there by Mackey. Three and a half minutes left to play. Spearman up 52-27. Stolen there by Pipkin. Pipkin has the fast break. Making a man miss. Twenty-one points now for Jack Pickin. That is sent back there by Davis.
And as the Spearman starting five, we get a round of applause here as they come off the court. Just under 3 minutes left. Your score 54-27.
Shot is blocked by Luke Flowers. Flowers spinning around. Not there. That's going to stay down here with Canadian. And there's a foul called there on number two. Kervin Quezada. That takes number three, Julian Dominguez, to the line. Makes a second shot. Good inbound there by Seaman. Out there to Kafka. Kafka shot, not there. We got, looks like a flagrant foul called on number 32, Seaman. Dominguez will be shooting some technical free throws here. Second shot is there for Dominguez. The Canadian will get the ball. Got a minute 55 here left to play. Miller has it. Dominguez. Quezada has it, getting pressured there by Dominguez. Foul we have called here. Minute 28 here left to play. Spearman inbounding. Garnett has it. Up to Quezada. To Kafka. Minute 15. And the shot there is no good. And Miller for three makes it. 54-32 with 45 seconds left here to play. And Kafka here. Looks like they're just going to try to dribble it out for Spearman. Has the ball with less than 20 seconds left. Dominguez. The Flowers. And Flowers gets called for a travel. Garnett here has it. Seconds here left to play. We're shooting 1-1. Score is 54-32. Garnett at the line. Garnett makes that one. Garnett misses the second one. And Miller over to Riggins. It's 4 seconds. And here at the end of this one, we have the Spearman Lynx taking the lead 55-32 over the Canadian Wildcats. I thank you all for tuning into this PTCI live stream here. And we'll make sure to like and subscribe.
You can manage your home Wi-Fi network right from your smartphone? With PTCI Whole Home Wi-Fi, you can quickly and easily manage your home Wi-Fi through your PTCI Wi-Fi app. Set your Wi-Fi password, view connected devices, run speed tests, set up parental controls, and more. Experience the best in home Wi-Fi with PTCI Wi-Fi app. Call now and get 3 months free of Whole Home Wi-Fi and visit PTCI.net to download the app today.